All right, are you ready? Let's get up and dance.
I'm gonna drive my car. Yeah, I'm gonna drive my car. And the wheels turn fast. And I'm gonna drive my car. Yeah, I'm gonna drive my car. And the wheels turn fast. And the world goes past. And I'm gonna drive my car. Yeah, I'm gonna drive my car. And the wheels turn fast. And the world goes past. And the lights go flash. And I'm gonna drive my car. Yeah, I'm gonna drive my car. And the wheels turn fast. And the world goes fast. And the lights go flash.
And I step on the gas.
I step on the gas. And I'm gonna drive my car. Yeah, I'm gonna drive my car. And the wheels turn fast. And the world goes fast. And the lights go flash. And I step on the gas. I step on the gas. And the engine blasts. And the engine blasts. And I'm gonna drive my car. Yeah, I'm gonna drive my car. And the wheels turn fast, and the world goes past, and the lights go flash, and I step on the gas. I step on the gas, and the engine blasts, and the engine blasts.
Look out, don't crash! Phew, that was close.
I'm gonna park my car.
Okay, we are back, and this time we're going to do some more cutting and pasting practice. You should have a sheet just like this in your bag if you need to stop and get that. You'll also need your scissors and some glue. And this we're going to work on putting in order. So this is a different kind of a sequence. This is going to be going first, second, and third. So the first thing we want to do is cut these out. And then we will try to decide which we think will happen first, second, and third. So if you go ahead and get your scissors, remembering your grip with your thumb and your fingers. Thumb here and two or three of your fingers or whatever works for you. But that's the best. I like to use three fingers. And cut this off the bottom. And then we'll just cut out our three pictures and then try to decide which we think comes first, second, and third. And then when we're all done, you can color these. Okay, so I have my strip. And then if we just cut between the pictures, we'll end up with three, and they will go in the squares at the bottom. Okay, so if we were going to grow our own flower, which do you think would be first, second, and third? Can you see those? This one looks like maybe some seeds and just a little plant. And this one is the plant in the watering can. Over here, it looks like we have the plant with the flower on it. So which of these do you think would probably happen first? Did you go with this one? I'm thinking that one, because you can see it's the seeds, the plant's real small. So we're going to put that one on our picture first. So if we get out our glue stick and just put some glue on there, put it over. And that will be first. So that's what would happen first. And then what happens next, do you think? Do you think you would end up second with that flower? Or would you have to water it first? I'm thinking we want to go with this one. So let's put that one on. So we've planted it. And then we've watered it. And it's gotten a little bit bigger. So then that leaves this one to go last, which would be right with, now it's grown into a pretty flower. So if we put that one on. So we have the seeds, and you water it, and it gets a little bit bigger. And finally, then you have a flower. So you can go ahead and color these. Any colors you like, just make some pretty flowers. And then maybe you can hang it up somewhere. Okay, we're back. And to finish up our LMNOPs book by Keith Baker. Do you remember where we left off last time? How about S? So there's our letter S. We're scientists, swimmers, and sailors on the sea. You hear all those S's? For letter T, we're truckers and teachers. Everyone look here, please. There's our letter U, for we're underwater divers. For letter V, we're voters, vets, and volunteers. You hear all those V words? And here's W, X, and Y. We're weavers and wishers and X-ray doctors, too. We're yogis in a pose. And zoologist. That's who. There's our letter Z. We are peas from A to Z. Now tell us, please, who are you? What are you going to do when you get grown up?
Count to 10 with a Mouse by Margaret Wise Brown. There was a little mouse, no bigger than a mole, who lived in a round place that he called a hole. He tried to count his nose, then he tried to count his toes. He said, "I'd better learn to count," so the story goes. One mouse took one look at one book that had one hole to run through. Two holes. Then the mouse ran through the book. The mouse ran through the book. He ran to the next page to take a little look. Three fish. And there what does he see? And there what does he sees? Three little fish swimming in the sea. Then the mouse ran through the book. The mouse ran through the book. He ran into the next page to take a little look. Four monkeys. And there what does he see? And there what does he see? Four little monkeys swinging in a tree. Then the mouse ran through the book. The mouse ran through the book. He ran into the next page to take a little look. Five butterflies. And here, great sakes alive, and here, great sakes alive. Here he found five butterflies. One, two, three, four, five. Then the mouse ran through the book. The mouse ran through the book. He ran onto the next page to take a little look. Aren't the butterflies pretty? All different colors. Six pussycats, and in among the mix, and in among the mix, six little pussycats are all in a fix. So the mouse ran through the book. The mouse ran through the book. He ran onto the next page to take a little look. I bet he didn't stay long on this page because mice are what kitties like. Seven apples. And there what does he see? And there what does he see? Seven little apples on an apple tree. And then the mouse ran through the book. The mouse ran through the book. He ran onto the next page to take a little look. Maybe he's a little hungry for an apple. Eight crows. And here is what he saw. And here is what he saw. Eight shiny black crows learning how to caw. Maybe we should count those. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Then the mouse ran through the book. The mouse ran through the book. He ran onto the next page to take a little look. 9 o'clock. Here everything is fine. The clock just struck 9. 9 o'clock is 9 o'clock and everything is fine. Oh, hickory dickory dock, the mouse ran up the clock. Then dockery hickory dock, the mouse ran down the clock. Then the mouse ran through the book, the mouse ran through the book. He ran onto the next page to take a little look. And when he's got to 10, and when he got to 10, he turned around the other way and ran right back again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. The end. Okay, you want to get out your My Spring book, and we're going to do the last two pages this time. And this one is, what do I wear in the spring? Well, let's see. It's been pretty rainy here lately, so I think I'm going to wear a raincoat. So, let's see. I'm going to try for this. I don't guarantee anything on this. Oh, maybe a shorter arm. Let's see. And we'll try for some fingers. Let's see. Maybe some rain boots. Let's see. And I bet there's some buttons on the coat. Well, and I guess I should have a face. Right, just like Mattman does. I'm gonna go ahead and give us ears like Mattman. And maybe some hair like we had on Mattman that time. Sort of looks like a crown, doesn't it? So I'm gonna go ahead and color my raincoat, which is usually yellow. But of course they come in all colors, don't they? You can have pink ones and purple ones. And I bet there's blue ones out there for the boys or the girls. What did you guys write down? Or draw, I should say. And remember, you color sort of small so you don't get out of the lines. And I'm going sort of fast, so remember you can pause it anytime you need to. I'm gonna have some color my black buttons in. So down here, have your adult help you write whatever you drawed. And I'm putting rain coat. There you go, rain coat. Now we're gonna move on to the next page. So pause if you need to finish up, or come back to it after we're done with the next page, whichever one you want. So this one says, what I'm going to do this summer. Now I'm gonna be in my garden a lot. So I'm gonna make some dirt, which I'm just gonna make sort of a little bit of a scribbly line here for my dirt. Then let's see, I'll probably have some carrots coming up. So we'll just see the top of their heads. Let's see. They'll have some squiggly stuff coming up from them. There's my carrots growing with the sun. Let's see, I'll probably have some stalks of corn. See, and at the top, there's some of the, I don't know if you can see that, that sort of blends in. And then, let's see, we'll have the corn growing off here. There's my corn. That'll have, I don't know if that looks like corn or not, but we're gonna say it's my corn. Almost looks like a flower, but we're calling it corn. So what are you guys doing? Are you going swimming? Are you Let's see, are you skating maybe? What else?
Playing baseball.
Oh, baseball would be a good one.
Playing at the park.
Yep. There's lots of things you could be doing, huh? So whatever you guys want to do, there's nothing wrong with what you're doing this summer, because there could be anything. Maybe you're just petting a cat. You can put a cat on there. Nothing's wrong with what you put on there. So that's what I'm doing. I'm playing in my garden. So that's the end of our spring book, guys.
Hi, and welcome back. This is going to be our last Matt Man in Motion for the year. So are we ready to get started and see what he's doing?
We are.
All right.
Here we go.
Matt Man has one head, one head, one head. Matt Man has one head to lay upon his pillow. Matt Man has two eyes, two eyes, two eyes. Matt Man has two eyes to close so he can dream. Matt Man has one nose, one nose, one nose. Matt Man has one nose so that he can smell. Matt Man has one mouth, one mouth, one mouth. Matt Man has one mouth so that he can snore. Matt Man has two ears, two ears, two ears. Matt Man has two ears to hear his wake-up call. Matt Man has one body, one body, one body. Matt Man has one body to hold what's inside. Matt Man has two arms, two arms, two arms. Matt Man has two arms to help when he rolls over. Matt Man has two hands, two hands, two hands. Matt Man has two hands to pull up his covers. Matt Man has two legs, two legs, two legs. Matt Man has two legs to lay upon the bed. Matt Man has two feet, two feet, two feet. Matt Man has two feet to kick off his covers.
There you go.
There's Matt Man. Do you know what he's doing?
I think he's sleeping.
He is sleeping. He's had a long school year and he's ready for some rest. So we're going to put Matt Man to bed for this year. Bye.
Bye, guys.
All right, we are back this week. I've got Miss Leeson and I'm Miss Kim here to do the last part of our review on our alphabet. So we are going to get started and we are doing letters S through Z today. So if you want to stop us at any time in these reviews and try to figure the letter out before you hear us say it,
that's fine.
Yeah, go ahead and see what you can do. All right, Miss Lisa, let's get started. What's our first letter today?
All right. It's going to be one with four big lines.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right, boys and girls, what do we can do with this? Let me see. I could make two of these.
Two of these?
Okay. Is that what you wanted?
No.
No, that's not what she wanted. All right, try it again. What happens if we put these two together? What will we have? You think this is what she wanted?
No.
Is that it? No, that's not it either. It's not what she wanted.
No.
All right, so we're going to try this. We're going to start over.
How about we give you a clue and it says, whoa, whoa.
Oh.
There you go.
Let's try it this way.
There's our last piece.
There you go.
There we go. I think that's what she wanted.
I think you're right.
We did it.
It's a W for whale. Now we're going to turn it over.
A whale. A W is hard to build upside down.
Yes, it is. But we did it. We managed to get it done. So there's our W. What's this one? That's it. That's our W, X, and Y. And W is a whale. Whale. Where's our other whale? There he is. We have watch and watermelon. And again, if you want to have your slates out and practice either with the wet, dry, try, your chalk, all of it, whatever, however you want to practice, it's great.
And here we have our uppercase W, our uppercase W, our lowercase W, and our lowercase W.
Good job. Oh, this is a tricky one.
Okay, this one's going to take two small curves. Okay. This one can be a little tricky. You can do it, Miss Kim. We have faith.
Miss Kim can do it. That's that upside down thing again. There we go. Nope, that's not it. Let's see. I'm struggling with these letters because they're upside down.
How about
let me turn this that way? Yeah, that's it. What do we have there? S.
Yep.
Letter S. Four. Whoops. There it is.
For sun.
Sun.
Good job. Now we're going to turn it over.
There we go. So there's our S. Where's our other S?
Yep.
So we have R, S, and T. So there's our sun. Sun. There's our matching sun. We also have snowman and square. And then we have it on the slates.
You can practice with. We have our uppercase S, our lowercase S, uppercase, and our lowercase.
There we go. All right, Miss Lisa.
All right. You need two big sticks for this one.
Brother, here we go with the sticks. The lines, lines, lines. That's right. They're lines.
Nope. Mm-mm. Oh, yeah. Mm. You got that one right away. Look at that.
What do you think?
Yep. What is that? What do you think at home? Do you know what that is?
Is that an X?
Nope.
Oh, are you sure?
I'm sure that's not an X.
It's not an X. She is right. I bet you know what it is. V for van. You guys at home and girls are doing an excellent job. You know these letters well, don't you? So there's our V.
And there's our V.
So what's this one? U. And a V. And a...
There's that W.
There's that W again. All right. Here's our V. Van. There's our matching violin and vase.
There's the slates you can try. You start with a smiley face. Don't forget that. Here's our uppercase V, our lowercase V, uppercase V, and our lowercase. If you want to try that at home. All right, for this one, you want to use two big lines.
Again with the line. Okay.
Well, you have them out. You might as well use them again.
Well, if we had a short one, a small line, I think we can make an H. But we don't.
But we don't. You can
and
only
we've
use
already
two.
Yep. Done our V, so it's not going to be that.
That's a V. You've already done that.
No, that's not it. Okay, I'm going to do this.
What is that?
What do you think?
I think you just made the letter.
I think so, too.
Let me put it beside.
Whoops.
There you go. There's the X.
Yep.
For X-ray. Good job. I'm going to flip it over.
All right. There's our X. You find the matching one? There's the X. So we have V, W, and X. So down here's our X-ray. Over here's our X-ray. And that's a xylophone. Lots of times the X, you don't hear it. So X is kind of a tricky one to hear it in words. There's our X. Same with our slate. You can practice those.
And there's our uppercase X and our lowercase. And they look the same, don't they?
Mm-hmm.
And our lowercase and our uppercase.
Yes.
Oh, this one's going to be a little bit tricky. You got two big lines and a small curve.
Okay, let's see. We can do this. Let's see what we're going to do. Well, we already know it's not the X. That doesn't do much for us. No. Where would you put this one?
Let me give you a hint. Okay. Down at the bottom.
Okay, there's our, she's told us at the bottom. Oh, there it is. What is that?
It's a U.
There's our letter U. Oops, move those off. All right, there's our U. And there it is right beside on this one. So we have U, V. There's our two U's, V and W. And we have a umbrella. There's our umbrella. And there's the map of our country, and that's the USA. That starts with the U and the officer's uniform. Slates, again, you can practice if you would like.
And we have the uppercase U, our lowercase U, and our lowercase U.
Very good. This one is going to be a little easier for us, isn't it, Miss Lisa?
Yep.
All right, let's try it, guys.
We got a big line and a little line.
All right, here we go. What do you think?
Oh. You know not your lowercase, one. Your lower letter. She made a lower letter of it.
You think it'll fit right there?
What do you think? Does she have it right? What letter is that? Do you guys know?
T.
Yep.
For turtle.
Good job.
Turtle. All right. There's our T. Where's our other one? Where's the... There it is. So what letter's that?
R.
S. And then our T again. So there's turtle, turtle, tub, and triangle.
And there's our slates to try it. There's our uppercase T, our lowercase, and our lowercase, and our uppercase. Okay, you've got a big line and two little lines to make this one. Oh.
Let's see.
I'll give you a hint.
All right, give us a hint.
A zoo animal starts with S.
Starts with the letter... Nope. That's not it, is it? Oh, this one has to slant. That's what we need to do. What do you think?
Yes, I think.
I think you're getting close.
Yep. I think we are too. So that sits on top of that. So where would that one go? I think we're getting close. Yeah, there it is.
Good job.
There's our Z.
And it's a zebra.
Yep.
Do you guys ever see a zebra at the zoo?
Mm-hmm.
I bet you do. Was that helpful, telling you that it started with a Z? Oh, and I even said zoo, and I wasn't thinking about that.
Z, and there's our other one. So we have an X, a Y, and a Z. Zebra. Zipper and a zigzag.
And here's your slates if you're working at home. Then you have your uppercase Z, your lowercase Z, and your uppercase Z. And they all look the same, just smaller.
This is our last letter. When we do this one, we will have reviewed over these last three sessions our entire alphabet.
Okay, you get a big line and a small line.
Okay, let's see what we can do. Is this another slanty letter, Miss Lisa?
Yes.
All right.
You got this figured out now.
I think we've got it.
Nope. Oh. Wrong side.
Oh, no. Now
I'll give you a little bit of a hint if you need
it. All right, give me a hint.
The little line needs on the other side.
Oh, other side. There it is.
Sort of, but you got to fix it a little bit.
All right, come on, Miss Nicole. There we are. Yay, we've done it. That is our letter Y. And now remember, if you were writing this, you would start at the top and then do your frog jump and then do it that way. There you go. That's our letter Y.
There you go. So now we're going to flip it over and review.
Where's our Y?
Right there.
And is this it?
That's a W.
That's an X. And that's a Y. And a Y says yarn. Where's our other yarn?
Yep.
And then there's a yo-yo and a yogurt.
And there's our slates, if you're reviewing them. And our uppercase Y, our lowercase Y, and our uppercase Y. And that's it, guys.
All right, that should be the entire alphabet. Good job.
We are back with Froggy the Weather Frog.
He looks like he's dressed for summer.
Yep.
But it's time to move on to fall. Yep. Some people call it autumn. It actually says autumn on your sheet. So it's either fall, autumn, same thing.
Yep.
So he's probably going to have to get rid of his flip-flops because it's starting to get a little cold.
Yeah, no more swimming trunks.
Yeah, no more sleeveless shirts. Yeah.
Whoa.
He might still want his sunglasses in the fall. You never know. It could be pretty sunny. We'll get rid of his summer shirt. So you might want to start wearing a sweatshirt in the fall. And we'll give him his sweatshirt.
Yep.
And let's see.
Probably some jeans.
Yeah, he'll want to go back to his long jeans probably. So we got, whoops. They're a little sideways. So there's his pants.
I bet it's going to be windy out.
It could be windy, yep. And our leaves, we start our leaves. But maybe we want to give him some shoes first. I'll probably have to get rid of the flip-flops and go with some tennis shoes. Fall's great. It's usually a lot warmer in the daytime and it cools down in the evening. Our leaves will start to turn, so we've got some fall leaves here. What else do we have? Oh, we have a fun, if you look at your card here.
We have two holidays.
Yep. One of them is, can you see
Halloween, and we have Thanksgiving.
So you can carve some pumpkins. There's lots of fall parties that a lot of times it'll be like bobbing for apples.
We get to apple pick.
Apple season, that's the fall. Maybe you've been to some of the mazes, some of the orchards and things have. That all goes on in the fall. So each season usually have some really fun things.
Holidays,
they do. It's fun. And we're lucky here in Ohio that we actually experience four seasons.
Yeah.
You know, if you live like maybe in the South, they have a winter, but it doesn't get as cold as it does here. And they usually don't have a lot of snow like we do. So we've covered a snowy winter, a rainy coming to life spring. Then we get into our hot, nice summer months and we'll end with autumn or fall.
Right.
So he's already probably to go to a football game.
Yeah.
Lots of football happens in the fall.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just a fun time of year.
That's right. Hello. So we've been talking about the seasons of the year with our weather frog. So as I read this book, Happy all year. I want you guys to listen to the months and then try to figure out which season they are with your adult. Okay? So keep this paper out and try to figure out the seasons as I read, okay? This is Happy All Year by Keith Baker. January. Happy January. Let's get going. Grab your mittens. Hooray! It's snowing. So if it's snowing, what would that be? That would be winter. February. Happy February. Deliver Valentine's. Count to 28 or leap to 29. March. Happy March. Wear a touch of green and look for leprechauns on day 17. So if it's March, have we changed seasons? April. Happy April. Walk through squishy mud. Splash in every puddle. Behold, a flower bud. So now we're into spring. May. Happy May. Grease up the rusty bike. Two flat tires. Who wants to take a hike? June. Happy June. Pack up. School's over. Clean out your messy desk. Roll in summer clover. So if it's June, what are we in now? July. Happy July. Chase the fireflies. Roll out a sleeping bag. Watch the sparkling skies. Do you know which season it is? Have you been looking at your paper? August. Happy August. Bait a fishing hook. Nap in cool shade. Reread your favorite book. August is hot, isn't it? So if it's hot, what would it be? September. Happy September. Grab a paper and a pen. Greet your eager teachers. School begins again. So if it's September, have we switched seasons? October. Happy October. Carve a toothy smile. Rake up all the leaves. Jump in every pile. November. Happy November. Open the sidewalk gate. Welcome all your guests. Fill every empty plate. We might be switching again. December. December's cold, so maybe we're switching seasons. Happy December. Tie a shiny bow. Light a glowing candle. Drink some hot cocoa. Together all around, pull each other near. Together we will have another new year. So we went through all the months. So we went through all the seasons of the year. So if you listen to the book, I told you all the seasons. We had spring, summer, winter, and autumn. So if you listened, you heard them all. If you need to go back and listen to them again with your paper, go ahead. Scary Mary by Paula Bowles. This is Scary Mary. In the barnyard, she ruled the roost. If the other animals came near, come and play. She chased them away. She made signs. Go away. Keep out. And she put up gates. And she practiced making scary faces. Look at those faces. She kept all the sunflower seeds to herself and built a fort to keep the others out. But can we join in? They asked excitedly. No, shouted Mary, and the animals scurried away, sending sunflowers flying. She squawked and clucked and crowed and flapped her wings in a terrific tantrum until she was completely alone. Look at all those feathers laying around. Finally, she had the barnyard and everything in it all to herself. She clucked by herself, played by herself, and ate dinner by herself. But without the others, she soon realized that being scary was lonely. So, when the other animals were playing, Mary asked, "Can I play too?" And they said, what do you think they said? Yes, because it was much more fun to do things together. The end.
Okay, today for our sequencing, we're going to make our version of a dragonfly. So I've got this one done. You will all have black and white beads, and that's the ones we're going to use today. But I thought I'd make this one a little different color so you could see a different pattern. But it's pink, blue, pink, blue, pink, blue, pink, blue, pink, blue, pink. So that's kind of how we're going to do it with our black and white ones. So we have three pipe cleaners. You should have this in your bag. Two little googly eyes, six white beads, and five black. All right. So we just want to take, and the pipe cleaners are all different colors. So you might have red, you might have green. It'll all work. So we just take our pipe cleaners, take your first pipe cleaner, and you want to just fold it in half. Kind of straighten it out as best you can. And fold that pipe cleaner right in half. Okay? So we've got that part done. Next, we're going to start putting our pattern over the folded end. So you want to put it over this end. All right? So for our pattern and with the beads we have, we want to start with black. So get a black bead and scoot it down over. And you're going to scoot it pretty far down on your pipe cleaner. All right? So then we would do white for our sequence. So we have a black and we have a white. What comes next? Black. This is actually a fairly easy pattern to do. We have black, white, black. What comes next? White. And then what? I think black. Does that look right to you? Black, white, black, white, black. So next is white. And then black. So what would be next? White. So we're staying with our pattern. Or our sequence, black, white, black, white, black, white, black, white. So that then it's going to be our last black. It'll go over here. And then we're going to finish this part with a white. And you should have one white bead left, which we will use here in a couple minutes. So there we have how it should look, and it tells us it's supposed to look, and that's what we have. Theirs are all green, but we did ours in a pattern. So we might want to just move these up a little closer there. So there's that. So now we take another pipe cleaner, our second pipe cleaner, and we just want to, it kind of shows here, and maybe it would be easier if you could see the direction. But what we're going to do is we're just going to take it and make a circle out of it. And kind of cross that. And then what we want to do is twist it around this end, or twist the ends around, so you don't have exposed ends. So when you're done, it should look like this one. So you want your ends kind of tucked in there. Okay, so now after we've done that, we've got our circle made with our ends tucked in as best you can. I think these pipe cleaners might be a little thicker than the ones they're using. So if your ends don't tuck in exactly right, it'll be okay, because that's how that purple one was. So now that we have our circle, we just take it and we kind of pull it and grab it in the middle. And that's going to make our wings. So that's our first set of wings. So then we take our, this part that we've done, and we want to put it down through this way. So there's how that goes. And then you'll just turn it and kind of twist these on each side so that it'll stay on there. And that makes your first set of wings. So I just kind of lay it down on your table or wherever you're working until you can kind of get that flat and fluff it up. However, these pipe cleaners will bend quite a bit. So you'll have a set of wings. All right. So now we want to take our last pipe cleaner and we want to make a smaller set of wings. So in order to do that, it tells us that we want to cut about an inch off. I don't think it has to be exact, but if you want to measure it, you can. But I don't think that is as important, as it just needs to be a little smaller. So we're going to just cut this at about an inch of it off. Oops. And it's probably more than an inch, but that's okay. And we don't need that, so you can just throw that one away. And we're gonna do the same thing we did with the last one. We're gonna make a circle. And we're going to twist this around to make it into a circle, trying to hide those ends as best you can. Just like that. And then we're going to make a smaller set of wings. So it's kind of the same thing. So then we want to stick this through. Actually, the smaller wings are supposed to go above. Not sure why it didn't tell us to put those on first, but we can stick them down over this way. That's our smaller set of wings. It says actually goes on top. So same thing. You just kind of twist it on both sides till you have an opening, and then it's on there. And if you need to lay it down on the table again, and then just kind of fluff them up. See, and then we have our sets of wings. Okay. All right. So then the next thing we want to do, which actually I think that one turned out, I have the wings opposite of this. So I really believe either way you put your wings on there will be fine. You take your last white bead and it's going to finish our pattern. Remember, there we were, white, black, white, black, white, black, white, black, white, black. And our last white one, you put it down over here, which kind of makes his neck. There he is. And again, you can kind of mess with your wings to get them however you want them, really. So there's your wings. Those need kind of fluffed up a little more. And you take these two pieces that are left, and that's what you're going to circle. It shows here. You're going to circle it into what's going to be his head, or her head, his or her, whichever you want yours to be. So we kind of make that into a circle. Oops, my wing came off. We make that into a circle. Push all that down a little bit. Twist that a little bit more. There's your wings. And there's your head. So the last thing you need to do is take your glue. And I found it easiest because these googly eyes are really small. Just put some glue on your... Whoops. Well, maybe I'll put some glue. I think my glue is clogged up. I don't know if a glue stick would work as well. I just used this one earlier this morning. There it goes. I think we got it. All right. Yeah, there it is. Oh, we just put a couple little dabs of glue. Try to pick up your googly eye. Put it right there on your glue. And then you're going to want to let that dry for a few minutes so your eyes don't fall off. And there he is. There's our dragonfly with our black and white pattern.
Hi, everybody. We are going to make some party hats for our fun party next week. So you should have gotten your kits with a blank hat. And we gave you a couple of just some items to get you going. A bug, I think, and a butterfly, and some paper and some flowers. But you can do anything you want to with them. They need to be fun, they need to be springy, and they need to be kind of crazy. So I wanted to show you what I did. But you can, like I said, you can do anything you want. So I started with my hat. Then I cut the top to make it look like grass. I put some flowers on it and a bug. And then what I'm going to do, because I want this to look like it's at the edge of the pond, I cut some splashes out. Let's see if you can see them. So I'm going to glue my splashes in there. And then I made this funny little fish. And I'm going to make him like he's jumping right out of my splashy hat. So that's my crazy hat for the party. But you guys can do anything you want. Be creative. You can use ribbons. You can use glitter. You can use paint. Markers. We gave you some letters to put your name on your hat. I haven't done that yet to mine, have I? But just have fun. And we will see you next week at our party. We're going to do some fun stuff. So be sure and wear your hat.